You have probably seen those Synthwave aesthetic mountains with digital sound. And maybe you wondered, how can I make it myself? Well, today I will show you how to build such simulation just from scratch. Without any engines, just C++ and raw OpenGL. Alright, first thing first, we need a space to render our neon magic. So let's start simple, just a basic window completely empty. Looks boring, of course. Let's change the background color a bit, give it some style, something closer to that Synthwave vibe. Well, that's look better. Before we move on, let's quickly talk about how all this magic is going to be rendered. You see, your computer has two main process units. The CPU, that's like the office manager, smart, good multitasking, but not really into drawing pretty pictures. Then there is the GPU. The over-caffeinated intern who only knows how to draw triangles, but does it very very fast. GPUs live on your video card, and they are built specifically for rendering graphics. So, if you want our mountains to glow at 60 fps and not at 6, we better give the job to the GPU. Thanks for attending my TED Talks on processing units. Now, let's back to Scott. Alright, the window is done, time to put something inside it. Let's start with the simplest shape in graphics, the triangle. Every object in 3D graphics is actually made up of many triangles joined together, so it's the most fundamental shape in our rendering. In our project we mostly need quads, but since OpenGL only knows how to draw triangles, we create a quad by combining two of them. Now let's piece it up with some shaders. We'll change the quad's color and add those iconic grid lines you always see in Synthwave renders. Right now, we have just a single lonely quad. But we can do better. First, let's give it a real 3D look by adding some perspective. Instead of rendering the quad with an orthographic projection, the object stays the same size no matter how far away they are. We will switch to perspective projection. This means objects farther from the camera will appear smaller, creating a realistic sense of depth and space in scene. Now it actually feels like it's floating in 3D space. You can clearly see how the sides of the quad appear to converge as they move farther away. That's the effect of perspective projection. It mimics how objects appear smaller when they are farther from the viewer, just like in real life. But one quad isn't enough, we need a whole grid. Let's create a surface made of many quads stitched together. Looks cool, now we can even play with this a bit. For example, it can be used for showing interesting shapes with basic trigonometric functions such as sinus or cosinus. Alright, time to bring this scene to life. Right now everything is static. Let's add some movement. A camera that slowly flies forward, straight into the horizon. Now that's better. The scene finally has life. Let's make our landscape way more interesting by adding some procedural generation. Instead of manually designing every bump and hill, we'll let the mess do the hard work for us. You might have heard about parallel noise before. If not, don't worry, I will explain it in a sec. Parallel noise is a classic algorithm used in tons of games and simulations to create terrarium, clouds, textures, anything that needs a natural organic feel. It generates pseudo-random noise. What you are seeing here is a 2D visualization of that noise. Just black and white values, kind of like static on an old TV screen. It's not truly random, instead it creates smooth, flowing patterns that look like something you would find in nature. But unlike pure randomness, there's hidden flow here. Bright areas blend smoothly into dark ones, and that subtle gradient is exactly what gives terrain its rolling hills and gentle slopes. Parallel noise can also work in 3D, but for our grid, 2D noises fits perfectly, since our terrain is essentially a flat 2D surface, where each point just needs a height value. We can interpret this noise map as a height map. Black areas represent low elevations, valleys or plains, while white areas become mountains peaks. I wrote a simple parallel noise implementation, and now our flat grid looks way more like actual mountains. Alright, now our terrarium look like a proper mountains. But there's one problem. I want the higher peaks to be on the left and right edges of the screen, and the center to stay relatively flat, like a valley or a road between them. To do that, we'll add our height values with a simple parabola function that's low in the center and higher near the edges. Much better. Now about colors. Right now it looks a bit dull. Let's add a smooth color gradient in this shader to give the mountains more life and that glowing neon vibe. The second key ingredient in our neon mountains scene is, of course, the sun. I decided to create it entirely in the shader, without textures. The sun really brings everything together at the depths, lights and the iconic synthwave vibe. And that's it, the final render is done. You can find the link to the source code in the description, along with the resources that inspired the project. I'd love to hear feedback about the video in comments. See ya!